Hello and welcome to this mini sub-series on understanding the Hindley-Milner typing rules. It's part of the wider Hindley-Milner series. In that wider series, we've covered a few things, including the lambda calculus expression syntax, the Hindley-Milner types, the Hindley-Milner contexts, along with, you know, assignments, judgments, and rules. And so rules are the real thing we're going to be exploring in this series. We've also looked at defining the free variables in types and in contexts, as well as substitutions, and discuss type order, and from type order we also get instantiation and generalization. So if you haven't seen any of those videos, you can go back and watch them now, or you can kind of plow ahead, and when you get stuck, maybe you can refer back to the relevant videos. The rough structure of these videos, there's going to be a couple ones on type proofs and type errors that are going to be structured slightly differently, but for most of the rules, we're going to read through the rule. We're going to explain maybe an intuition or reasoning about why it makes sense, why it would be doing what you might expect. And then we'll look at some practical examples of where the rule applies and maybe how to apply it formally. So of course, we'll go into these rules in more detail in the next few videos. I'm just going to put them up here if you want to pause and have a look at them, maybe try and figure out what they mean. But honestly, at first viewing, they are pretty dense, pretty hard to read unless you've already been doing a lot of logic or looking at typing rules before. But they each correspond to an expression and instantiation and generalization. So here we have variables, applications, abstractions, let bindings, instantiation, and generalization. So see you in the upcoming videos to explain what all these crazy symbols mean.